thanks very much to the members of the media for coming this morning to cover this important topic. I want to thank my fellow senators as well for their leadership on this very important issue and this important cause today. And I'm proud to stand up here and call for an end to gap elimination, which sounds like a defensive scheme used on Super Bowl Sunday. But it was a scheme. There's no question about it. It was a gimmick implemented in 2010 when Democrats controlled Albany to close that massive budget deficit. But the results of the GEA have been incredibly damaging. Less funding for local schools meant fewer teachers in the classroom, students lumped together in larger classes, more financial burden shifted to local taxpayers. It was a short-sighted decision then, and it is only worse today. In 4 years, New York schools have lost $9.5 billion, and over 35,000 school employees have been laid off. Schools in my district, in the 55th district, in Monroe and Ontario counties, have lost over $120 million as a result of the GEA. Seniors who will walk across the stage to accept their diplomas this spring went to class under those funding cuts for their entire high school careers. It's unfair, and it needs to change. At a time when we're talking about reforming our public education system, certainly repealing the GEA is one of the most common sense ways to achieve positive results for our schools and our taxpayers. And I would encourage all of my colleagues on the other side to work with us to get this done. Thank you.